Good morning. This is the 10th class. This class we more concentrate on all these three. The regular language, that is the type 3 language with left linear grammar and right linear grammar. Regular language is very much related with regular grammar. So every regular language has a regular grammar, definitely. And regular expression, that we know little bit earlier, that regular expressions comes with like whenever you are using ls a start dot c, like this kind of command we can grep, or in vi editor in Linux, the same can be done by regular language. And another side is finite automata, definitely deterministic finite automata, which can be designed in hardware. And another is non-deterministic finite automata, which can be converted to the finite automata. So all four are same. That is the reason it is shown by this diagram. Now, what is regular grammar? That I have covered in lecture 9. That is lecture 9 is the left hand side is only a single variable, same as a context free grammar also. Context free grammar and regular grammar, all the production rule, left hand side only one and only single variable. But the difference is, in the regular grammar, there can be only right hand side only one variable that can be at the end, then we call the right linear grammar, and before that maybe one or more terminal, or another rule can be a variable and only one or more terminal, no other variable. This is right linear grammar. And if it is the variable comes at the beginning, like left linear grammar at the beginning, all the terminals are single terminal. And the right, then it is called left linear grammar. So this is a regular grammar, two types, right linear and left linear. Like this, what is the use of regular grammar? Very much used whenever you try to name the, like this, an identifier in any C, Java, Python. So we know that it must start with a letter, and then anything letter, or it can be anything letter on digit. So it can be letter or it can be digit. That is nothing but FSM description. So this is the, just a minute. Yeah, this is the identifier in a C language. It should start with a letter, and later on it can be letter or digit, any combination. Which term means it can be zero or more combination. This is an example of regular grammar also, regular expression also. And it can be done with finite state machine. That's great. So this is the hardware which accepts only language A, only single A, not more than A. It should be some concentric circle here. So there is one mistake. It should be, this is the start, and here this language accepts A, B. So A and B. So there should be one more concentric circle should be there, showing as a finite state. This is A or B, like you can go this state through A or through B. It should be accepted state, accepted state or final state. And A star, that means I can have one or zero repetition, I can reach there. So if there it should be also concentric circles, so it accepts the language A star. This I covered in one of the lectures. This is also covered. So most of these regular expression we already know in VI editor, even the DOS editor. Whenever you give a command start dot C or start dot star, star is nothing but a regular expression. Yes, this is a regular expression. There is difference between epsilon and psi. Epsilon means the language accepts an empty string. This empty string epsilon, in some books it is written in lambda. So both are same. So the language accepts an empty string. If nothing happens, language accepts. But here, there is another language which is shy. The language doesn't accept any damn thing. So there is heaven and hell difference. This is language accepts empty string, that is it, epsilon, and language accepts, language is empty string, and shy means language doesn't accept anything. Like a finite state machine, no accepting state, so language doesn't accept anything. So this is a set notation this is a set notation where the language accept R1 union R2. That means it is OR. This is regular expression. We can say it R1 plus R2. And this is concatenation operation. This is R1 dot R2. And this is star means a zero or more definition, recursive definition. Some examples of regular expression, like alphabet is AB. So with A, so this is the notation of regular set and this is the expression. So this is a regular set and this is a regular expression. Please do not confuse, they look very similar. This is the language, say it is concatenate AB, but in set notation AB, or better is A union B, bracket A union within bracket B will come. This is A union A comma, it should be A. Another expression is A union B. This is A plus, that means at least one occurrence of A. So this is a regular set description, this is a regular expression. This is regular set and regular expression, very similar. So please don't confuse. Whenever you see regular set, you see the union operation U intersection like this with opening bracket close, begin and close like Python set. AB star represents a set of strings, a single A and followed by zero or more occurrence. So this is regular expression, this is a set, this is a regular expression, this is a set, same thing is expressed in regular set, this is regular expression and this is regular set. So that is a regular set notation. Set notation is like this, regular expression is like this. This is better, my belief is, always suggest you go for this kind of regular set expression. So here, comma is also there, but comma is nothing but union. Comma you might confuse with dot, dot is concatenate operation. So it is better, regular set you show by union. This is union, this is one or more. This is concatenation operation, yes, and this is union. The equivalent regular expression is this. It is much simpler. So don't forget about this. You prefer regular expression, you follow this, and regular set, the same thing, you can follow this. All, both are equivalent. Like here, A star BB union, this lambda is epsilon. In some books, lambda is epsilon. So I have told in earlier classes, some of the conventions I am taking it from best books and literature. So don't confuse, this lambda is expression, this is set notation, union, and this is the, so you can see regular expressions is nothing but you are using your DOS command, your Unix command, we generally use to give this kind of command in. So regular expression you already know, whenever you are from class 8 or 9, you use this command regular expression in your command, in DOS command or Linux command. But this is a little bit maybe, but both are same. Language of regular expression like this. This is a language. This is language. If you just put L, that is the, what are the languages? So if it, this is a regular expression, not set. This is a regular expression. What are the sample languages? Like these are the sample languages. It come either A and then either A or BC or this, all these things. Either A and you take no occurrence and this A can be there, BC. BCA can be there. Say first you take BC and next time you take only A, not BC. So BCA comes it here. So this is a, with this simple regular expression you can have produce infinite language. That is the beauty. Though I call a finite state machine, it doesn't have stack, but it can accept. It can accept infinite language, which can be described by regular set or regular expression. Okay, so that's a great thing. So the regular, this is the regular expression, it can get infinite languages, but not sigma star. Sigma star means all languages. So sigma star means if you put your finite state machine, all are in accepting state, so that is sigma star. But that is also infinite language, and This is also an infinite language. We know the Gregor-Kant theory, it is both infinite and number are same. You can give the language number 1, 2, 3, so that both are the, as a, ordinarily both are same. So, this is the regular expression. Practice, so it is have to be a practice to this. So, like this, all string containing exactly two A's, definitely two A's, so definitely A, you put A here, and all these things make it in optional, B, C, anything optional. So, this is a regular expression for, this is a language. So, language you can describe like this, all string containing exactly two A. In exam, you have to find it out, this kind of exam, you have to find it out what is the regular expression or regular same. Regular expression is much easier to write, because if you have to regular set, you have to write it union, and this is concatenation operation. So, expression is much better. So, this needs practice. But you might say whether that is unique, whether this pattern is it? No, it can be. Pattern can be complex, but at least you have to write one paper, one pattern. All strings containing no more than three A's. So, here is the same technique. We put it here, A here, A here, and A here, and lambda means epsilon, and all this combination. So, this is a regular expression for this language. So, this, but great is, this thing can be converted to deterministic finite automata. That's great. So, regular expression, again, expression I told you much simpler. And language, it is a regular set, and I have covered it. Set is union, plus and is in this thing. So, plus is in regular expression, and what is union in here. So, expression is much simpler. This is same thing, like I have told you in earlier class also. If epsilon means it accepts null. Null, it accepts empty string. Empty string in some books lambda, and shy means it doesn't accept anything. You just practice all this thing. Thank you for being this.